Okay, so let's look at how to apply displacement maps when applying a pattern or texture or a logo to a piece of clothing. Generally, you would do this if you're displaying a t-shirt design on a t-shirt before you actually get it printed. For this assignment, though, we just need it on a minimum of a shirt, so you can go pretty wild, do a whole suit, do a dress, whatever strikes your fancy, as long as it has at least the minimum of a shirt. Now, I cannot strongly recommend enough that you make sure that you begin with a copyright-free image or an image that you've taken yourself of someone wearing white or light clothing. You do not want to try to do this assignment with dark clothes. It will make it incredibly difficult and will just make your entire time just miserable experience as you get going into it. So here I have my classic demonstration model. She's wearing light clothing that has the light on the top left, which is great for displacement maps. It tends to make it work out just a little bit better. So we're going to apply eventually a displacement map to the cloth. But in order to do that, you really need to have just the clothing and not everything else. So you do that through masking. And as shown in other videos I have posted, the pen tool is phenomenal for that, given that these are hard edges. If you had soft edges, you'd want to go back to the same sort of masking techniques used way back in the early assignments where we were doing postcards, and you had fuzzy hair and things like that. But for this, you can use the pen. So even though we have this kind of bloom effect going along the edges of this, this will still work quite nicely. In order to use the pen properly, since the pen is one of these path tools, notice in the older versions of Photoshop, they used to delineate the tools with a line. The newer versions, they got rid of that for some reason, but essentially you had your brush tools in one section, and then you had your vector tools in another section. What we're going to do is bring open the path window, and we'll do that by going to window and select paths. Notice that I'm just going to go ahead and dock that with layers since I'm not going to need them all in one go. And I'm going to go ahead and select an area to work on. Let's use the smallest area here would be the top of her dress. Because this is broken up by her arm, we can work directly in this area. So I'm going to go ahead and start with a pen tool. I'm going to zoom in enough so that I can actually see what I'm doing. I'm going to grab the pen tool. I'm going to just click, click, click away. Hopefully you did the exercises that I posted online for Bezier curves. I think that that's a great way to learn. But notice it's pretty straightforward. If you've done those exercises, you just click and drag in order to create a curve. You can alt-click the previous section if you want to break that so that it's not connected to the previous one. Notice that I get the little V shape on my pen tool icon. Of course, if I had the caps lock key on, I just have this target icon, which doesn't work very well for this. You definitely want to make sure you have caps locks off so that you just have your pen tool. I want to continue the line. I hit some buttons and did some stuff to continue the line. I just click on it again. It will produce this little slash on it, and then I can keep going. So I'm just going to click along and alt click to break that apart. Alt click. If you're having problems seeing what you're doing, if the skin tones or if a background is as light as the clothing that you're working on, the easiest way to deal with that would be on your layers palette. Just add a temporary adjustment layer of levels. So I'm going to grab the levels adjustment layer, and that will let me darken things up substantially. Notice, however, since I clicked it while I had this pen going on, I've created this vector maps mask already, and I did not want to do that, so I'm going to undo this a couple of times real quick. I'm actually going to come back to the paths channel. I'm going to save what I have so far. Right now it's by default called a work path. If you double click it, it will be the same thing as telling it to save path, which is just this little sticky note icon in the bottom right. Instead of path one, will be descriptive top of dress, top of dress. All right, and so now I can click off of that. Then in layers, now I can go ahead. Whoa, my bad. I can go ahead and go to the adjustment layer. I accidentally missed and I hit the mask icon. Go to the adjustment layer and do a levels adjustment. Now, I could just darken this up a whole lot so I can see what I'm doing. Remember, as an adjustment layer, I can just turn this off at any time. It's a non-destructive manner. So I'm going to go back to my top of dress, and I want to edit this so I can do a couple of things. If you right-click on it, you'll have the duplicate path, delete path, make selection, all that stuff. I just want access to it, so I'm just going to click it once, and then it will bring it up. Notice now when I mouse over it, I can go back to it. I will get this icon at the very end that has a line with a dot in the middle, a little square. If I click there, it will allow me to continue to work with the stored mask. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. So now I can see a little bit better what I'm doing. If I need to move something, if I've missed, Control key will allow me to convert it into the direct select tool, which is just this one right here. Notice it's the direct selection tool. Isn't that great? You don't have to get out of what you're doing. Notice too, here are all the options. You have the pen tool, freeform pen tool, which is great if you have a Wacom tablet, or Wacom tablet, however they like to pronounce it. That lets you draw the path straight away. Add anchor point in case you missed, delete anchor point in case you really missed, and convert point. That's what allows you to switch out from a curve to a straight line, an edge, that kind of thing. So I'm going to use the plus here, but now I need to move it. Control key, that'll let me get closer. Nice. All right, so I can pick up where I left off, and then I just keep clicking and clicking and clicking. So this takes a long time, but the end result is definitely worth it. So you click away, you click away. Now to save you time, just to demonstrate how to work with these paths, I'm just going to go ahead and close up a really not super great path. And guess what? I made a path earlier. It's kind of like a cooking show. You don't want to have the whole audience waiting 3 hours while you cook something. So I'm just going to do a pretty raw path here that will be incorrect, but will still give you an idea of how all this works. Spacebar to convert to the hand tool so I can drag around. All right, so I've got the top of the dress. Like I said, if it were a new path, then you'd have a working path going on. This is not a new path though. I'm still on the top of the dress. So if I want to get off of that, I can simply deselect it and get away from it. But what I, or click the new path button and you can work on new path, any of that good stuff. Anyway, once you have this path stored, and if, or if you wanted to, you could create a new path and then draw another path for the next piece, all that good stuff. Once you have this path stored, you can load it later as a selection. Fastest way is to right click on it and tell it make selection, and we'll give you some options. Do you want to have a feather radius? Not in this case, Andy Ellis is fine. I want a new selection. You can also add to selection, subtract from selection, and intersect with selection. So you have a shirt that's getting cut up by, say, an arm. Then you would do two paths, and you would add to selection at this point, so you get them all together. Let me tell you and show you what I mean. So that's how you store these things. That's how you make them. Let's close this up and open up the completed one. Voila, we've got all of these pieces. So we're going to come in. We're going to load these up. So I'm going to start with the top left part. You can see the path of the dress. I'm going to make a selection out of that. I'm just going to right click, make selection, and it will be a new selection. Voila. But if I want to add on, say, the bottom left half of the dress, and what do I mean by that? Well, we can take a look. Notice this hand is breaking it apart. So that will be the left half. You can also, instead of right-clicking, you can go over to the Make Selection, Load Path and Selection button. But oh no, what happened? It didn't give that option menu. That's terrible. Well, what you can do instead of right-clicking is hold down the Alt key and click the Make Path and Selection. That will bring up the Make Selection window. So what I'm going to do is add to the selection. And now I've got two of the pieces. I've got a bottom right chunk I want to add to that. So I'm just going to right click this time, right click, make selection, immediately brings up the window. I'm going to add to selection. Voila, look at that, we've got all these selections. So what do you want to do now? Well, you could make a mask out of this. You just basically click the mask, but we don't need it right now. In fact, we want to apply it later after we've done the displacement map. So what you would do is actually save it. So inside of channels, you can see I've already saved one. You can save another one. I've got all these selections and I have some options. If you mouse over, you can load a channel as a selection. You can save a selection as a channel. Ah, and you could create a new channel. Let's go ahead and save selection as a channel. Voila, we've got the alpha 2, which is just the mask. That can be loaded in later. And you can do that by, while you're on RGB, click on the alpha mask. Let me deselect. Click on the alpha mask. There are a couple ways. Easiest way is to load channel as selection. Bam, we've got the selection. All right, click back on RGB. Turn off the eyeball on alpha 2. So in other words, by doing that, by clicking back on RGB, I was no longer activating the mask that I stored called it Alpha 2. It's a terrible name. Let's call this left dress. That's better. Save while you work. All right, by clicking RGB, I was no longer looking at the left dress. By turning the eyeball on and off, you can see what it would look like even though RGB is selected, which is actually really great. It's a nice little preview. See what's happening. You can also see that it's looking pretty good except for the hair. I didn't do that just yet. In fact, we'll probably leave it for this example. All right, so you want to do that for the other one as well. Voila, you've got everything loaded. In the case of the leg, what you do for that is after you've painstakingly made the path around the leg, painstakingly made the path around the dress, you can go in, you can load in the right one. I'm just going to right click, make selection, new selection. And now you need to get rid of that leg. You've made another path painstakingly with the pen tool. And then you'd come into the right leg here. And this time I'll hold down the Alt key. Again, right clicking is fine, just to show you different ways. You have the subtract from selection option. Voila. You have both things selected, which means you can make another channel. Do it that way. That's fine. I'm doing it a little differently. I'm just making the channel first. Going to fill it with the background color by doing Control Delete. Voila, got another alpha mask. Cool. All right, so now I've got everything I could possibly need to start applying the displacement map, and we'll do that in the next video. Thank you.